All right, self-monitor your microphone. Please mute, not speaking. Only unmute when you are speaking. In this meeting, everyone has a chance to speak, believe it or not. Sit quietly while watching speeches. Grab your popcorn, grab a cup of coffee, and enjoy the speeches because that's what you've come for. Show appreciation to the speakers. You can clap. Or you can wave, be engaging while on the call. Guests, please enter your contact information in private chat to Agnes Katushawe because she's a vice president membership. You want her to get back to you. I'm sure she will share something like a form where you can also put in your contact information. Speakers, you may pin or unpin the timer. Is Viola, I believe, today. For best results while speaking, set your camera at eye level. You still have a chance to turn on your camera if you're a speaker and test your microphone and camera. See if you're big or not. To participate in the round robin evaluation, please put your name in the chat. Or raise your hand. We'll talk more about the round robin evaluation later. Hey, guests, Toastmasters, and everyone on the call, please turn on your video wherever possible. I'll lead by example. My video is off, I've just noticed. Yes, this makes it easy for the speakers and people to enjoy the meeting, I guess. Please rename. If you're a role taker, let us know what role you're taking. If you're a guest, you can put guest before your name. Or if you're a club officer, let's know what position you have at the club. I'll also lead by example. I'll rename shortly. Everyone on the call, listen actively because everyone here will offer feedback to the speaker during the round robin evaluation segment. This is what every speaker has spoken. You will be able to give them your feedback. What did you like about the speaker's speech? What do you think the speaker can improve on their speech? Or what are your thoughts about the topic of the speaker? This feedback is very crucial for the speaker's journey because they learn through your evaluation. So be generous. Evaluation is a gift for the speaker. We can't emphasize that more. Lastly, this is my last slide, our club mission. You can read it quietly to yourself. Don't unmute, otherwise you cause an echo. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. That's what we do at Toastmasters and at Kampala Sunrise. We tell our stories and we grow through storytelling. And now, without much further ado, before I introduce our Toastmaster of the day, I want to hear from a few guests. We have quite guests today. I see top of my list. Let me see. Peter Muganga. Good morning. Please unmute and greet us and tell us where you're dialing in from.
Good morning, Alex. Good morning, Toastmasters. I am Peter Muganga. I am happy to be here. I am dialing in from Bokoto.
Good to have you here, Peter. Other guests. Bruce Gomwe. Bruce. Good morning, Bruce. Please unmute if you can and tell us where you're dialing in from.
Oh, yes. Good morning, Toastmasters.
Good morning.
My name is Bruce. Happy to be here once again. I'm getting a meeting from Abu Dhabi.
Wow, we have international caller. One more guest. One more guest. Vanita Gaba. Good morning. Tell us where you're calling in from. What's your expectation this morning?
Okay, good morning. Yes, my name is Vanita Gaba. I'm calling in from Bulova. And yeah, I'm here to learn and have fun. Yes.
I like that, to learn and have fun. Rest yourself, because this meeting is promising to be a fun one. And now, she is the first Vice President Education at Anchored Toastmasters Club. She is the current president at Anchored Toastmasters Club. She is a past humorous speech contest champion at her area. She is everything, but won't really, I can't have enough time to list her biography, but she's also today's host of the meeting, our Toastmaster of the day, Caroline Maundu Mbibe. Caroline, please take it away.
Thank you, Mr. President, for that wonderful introduction. It's an honor, it's a privilege to be visiting Kampala Sunrise Toastmasters Club. Good morning, Kampala members and guests. How are you today? How are you feeling? Please respond in the chat so I can know how you're feeling today. I'm excited. I've always wondered about how clubs that have morning meetings manage every single time, but I can see why scheduling a meeting early in the morning can energize, inspire, and set the pace for a great day. Today, we get to hear speeches and wonderful evaluations and enjoy 1 hour of inspiration and encouragement. So I welcome you all to this meeting 101, and I congratulate Kampala Sunrise Toastmasters on a milestone of having made 100 meetings. Now, today's theme is very short and sweet, and it's about kindness. Have you experienced kindness in your life, whether it's a random act of kindness or deliberate kindness from your family, friends, and how did it make you feel? What were your thoughts? So today we're going to look a bit, to delve deeper into what kindness does and why kindness is an important aspect in both our personal lives and in the lives of the people we live with. So today's meeting is structured in three parts. We have our role takers. We have two role takers today. We have the timer and the grammarian. Then we'll move to our prepared speech session. We have two speakers today who are ready to give us riveting speeches. And then lastly, we'll have the evaluations. Please note that we'll have the round robin evaluations. So in addition to the designated evaluator for each speech, the floor will be open to have evaluations from those in the room. Please pay attention so we can give our speakers feedback that will help them as they continue to improve their speaking skills. And now I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce my first role taker for the day, and that's our timer, Momugisha Viola. Momugisha, please tell us a moment you've experienced kindness as you introduce your role today.
Hello, good morning, Sunrisers. Hello.
Good morning, Viola. We can hear you.
Oh, yeah. Thank you, Caroline, for that intro. It's already a kind moment for me. I'm excited this morning to take on the role of a timer. It's the first time I'm doing this, so I'm super excited. My role is simple. I'll be monitoring the time used by the speakers and the evaluators. Yeah, so literally for speeches, when one clocks 5 minutes, I'll flag green. When a speaker clocks 6 minutes, I'll flag yellow. Then when at 7 minutes, I'll flag red. For evaluators, green will be for 2 minutes, yellow will be for 2.5, red will be for 3 minutes. Yeah, that's how I'll run my timing. Thank you, Carol.
Thank you so much, Viola, and congratulations for taking the leap and starting by being a timer today. Our second role taker is our grammarian, who will be doubling up as our counter. And this is Ochao de Gratias. Please forgive me if I have butchered your name, but please go ahead and introduce your role and tell us of an experience you've either shared kindness or you've experienced kindness. Over to you.
I don't think Ochao is here yet, unless we have a volunteer who would want to take on that role, we can skip it till he comes back.
Thank you, Mr. President. Do we have volunteers on the floor? Going once, going twice. All right, we'll wait for Ochao to be back. And now, ladies and gentlemen, did you know that kindness affects your mental health, that doing good acts can positively lift your mood? Well, scientists tell us that by extending grace and positivity to others, we get to receive it in return. And by allowing ourselves to view others and to extend goodness, we also get to see the good in ourselves. So if you're having a challenge today, or you're feeling overwhelmed or feeling inadequate, just take a pause and appreciate someone in your life, something they've done for you, or encourage someone else as they go on. So my encouragement to you today, even as we start this day, take a moment, text someone or call a friend, tell them that they're doing great, encourage them to keep going, even if they're facing a challenge. Not only will it make them feel good, but it will also make you feel good. I'd like to start on our speakers today. We have two speakers. Remember, we'll have a round robin evaluation session after the main evaluator is through. So please take your notes so we can give feedback to the speaker. Our first speaker is Juanita Nangobi. Juanita will be evaluated by Agnes Katushabe. Agnes, please give us the speech title and objective of Juanita's speech.
Thank you, Madam TM Odi. Good morning, Toastmasters and guests. I'm honored this morning to be evaluating Juanita Nangobi. Remember, like that TM Odi mentioned, can you hear me? Please confirm if you can hear me. Awesome. So Toastmasters and guests, remember, like the TMOD mentioned, we have an opportunity to do a round robin evaluation. So please take note as I read out Juanita's speech objective. So the purpose of Juanita's speech is to deliver a speech with awareness of intentional and unintentional body language, as well as to learn, practice, and refine how she uses nonverbal communication when delivering a speech. She will present a well-organized speech on any topic. Please look out for that body language and let's provide her with feedback of how she will have done so she can grow. She can give us her speech in a way that's humorous, informational, or any style that she chooses. Juanita's speech title is Hello. Hello Joanita Nangobi.
Hello. My name is Joanita Nangobi. I did a Bachelor of Science in Biotechnology, and currently I'm pursuing a Master of Science in Pharmacognosy and Natural Product Development at Makerere University. Nice to meet you. Oh, wow. You did biotechnology. I did the same at my undergraduate level. It's a pleasure to meet you, Joanita. The story continues, and in my mind, I'm glad I made a friend. Thank you, Madam Toastmaster, dear Toastmasters, and distinguished guests. The world we are living in today is basically built on our social networks. And the quote, "Your network is your net worth," has gained credibility more than ever before. However, we are now living with the word hello and sometimes not realizing how impactful it can be, because probably we are not paying attention when saying this simple, powerful, five-lettered word. Hello. Robert Broad once said that charisma is not just saying hello, but putting aside what you are doing and say hello. When you say hello in the right way, it can do a million things. It can change a frown to a smile. It can change two strangers to great friends. It can reconnect people or lost relationships, lost friendships that were probably separated. And just by saying hello, you get your friend back. It can take someone from a bad mood to a good mood. And it can also open conversation that can change the trajectory of one's life. And from the latter, in 2022, as I was finalizing my undergraduate university studies, I decided to say hello to some of my lecturers. Fast forward, I have found myself obtaining a scholarship to complete my master's studies. I have found myself in fancy, elegant places, attending well-paid workshops. I have found myself being considered for great tasks and positions to take up, and many more. And sometimes I sit back and I ask myself, how has all this happened? And the answer that comes to my mind is that memory on that beautiful day when I decided to interact with the people that are now the source of these opportunities. Hello, it can be an acronym. H, how are you doing? E, everything all right? L, I would like to see you soon. I would love to interact with you. And oh, obviously, I would love to catch up again with you. Usually, it is also accompanied by various small tasks. For example, making eye contact with a person, stretching out your hand, smiling, and then say hello. When you are in a conference room and you're feeling petrified and uncomfortable, because you feel afraid to stand up, allow yourself and walk to someone and say hello, remember that there is a chance that someone else is also feeling the same way. And in the end, both of you are losing to make a friend, a connection, a network, a person who could probably become your business partner. I look forward to a world where we are more compassionate, where we are more kind, where we are more friendly, where we are sharing opportunities to one another. And this starts with saying a hello. You and I can become the champions of this cause. But the question this morning is, are you willing to be the first person to walk up to someone and say, hello? Back to you, Madam Toastmaster.
Fantastic, inspirational. Thank you, Juanita, for such an informative, inspiring speech. And now I'd like to welcome Agnes to give us her evaluation. Then we'll open the floor for evaluations from the rest of the participants in the.
Awesome. Thank you, Madam Toastmaster and Joanita Nangobi. Well done. What a captivating speech. I totally enjoyed it. And I agree with someone in the chat who says wonderful speech. On to your speech objectives. I'll start with that. Hand gestures and how you use them, your body gestures. In my opinion, you have intentionally used those gestures. I saw them. I noticed when you were comparing different scenarios, talking about a change from a frown to a smile, where you would move from this other side to this other side. You know, there is a frown, and on the other hand, there is a smile, and similar incidences when you did that. Then you talked about getting your friend back. I saw that gesture, and then stretching out your hand. There were a couple of those that I saw, and I thought they were very effective in communicating your message. What could you have done better in that area of gestures? I believe it's still a learning journey, even for me. I was challenged to even go back and research a little more, how should those hand gestures be like? But I would like to think for now, and for this speech, they have been used effectively, perhaps just to emphasize, you know, like when you are showing the difference, to be a bit more consistent when you are showing the different sides of situations, for us to clearly see them coming out properly. But to add to the positives of your speech, I even like that your camera was well positioned, that we could see the gestures very well. So that added to your speech and made it even better. Then on to other aspects of your speech. I liked the title. It was captivating. I was looking forward to know, what is this hello all about? And it blended in so well with the message of your speech. Then it felt like you were very comfortable on the stage. The acronym that you used was also spot on, because then it helps us to remember what your speech is about. And we were inspired this morning to take that step and say hello to someone, knowing what doors that hello could open. So over to you, Joanita, and I look forward to more of your speeches. Over to you, TMOD.
Thank you so much, Agnes. Thank you for that enriching and helpful evaluation. And now for the exciting round robin session, I'd like to get some volunteers, but let me volunteer someone. Let me see who will be our lucky first speaker. Can we have Charlotte go and give us your evaluation of Juanita's speech?
Good morning, Caroline, and good morning, Toastmasters from Sunrise. I had a feeling you were going to pick on me. Great. My evaluation of Juanita's speech would be based largely on the audio version of it, because of it's morning, we are preparing to leave and go to work. So what would I say? I would say that I loved your introduction, Juanita. You captivated us with how you started your speech. And I think through it, it's important to, you know, to say hello. I thought so. And so today I've learned also something new. I've learned that hello can also be an acronym. And please post it once more in the chat so that we have that for memory. I thank you for your courage. I thank you for the confidence, because sometimes speaking up and sharing our stories is something that not everybody can do. So congratulations on that. And I want to wish you the very best, even as you continue in your Toastmasters journey. Thank you very much, Caroline. That will be it for me. Thank you.
Thank you, Charlotte. Thank you for that wonderful, insightful evaluation. It's a benefit to all of us. And now I'd like to call on Peter Muganga. Could you please go ahead and give us the evaluation of Juanita's speech?
Good morning, Toastmasters. Juanita's speech was really good. I like that she used the stage quite well. The positioning of the camera was good, and the title of the speech was captivating. The speech also flowed. It had a beginning body and a conclusion remark. So I really enjoyed the speech. I have no problem with it. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Peter. Indeed, that was helpful. So I'd like to leave the floor for one more person. Now I'll wait for a true volunteer. Anyone, you can raise your hand or post it in the chat so I can pick you. Okay, let me see. How about Viola? Viola, would you like to give the last evaluation for this speech?
Oh yes, let me give it a try. So I was quite impressed by Joan's speech. I must say, Joan, you took me in your story, and you know, I followed through your success with Halo, like how Halo paved way for you, for example, to get your scholarship. It was really so fun for me to follow. I enjoyed every bit of it. Yeah, that's what I can say. Thank you.
Good job. Thank you so much, Viola. Overall, Juanita, you gave us a riveting speech, told us to say, ask how we're doing. Hello is how are you doing? And extend, hold on, let me get my notes. Yes, is everything okay? And I would love to interact with you. Juanita, please post the rest of the acronym for us in the chat so that we can implement it today. Overall, thank you so much for that speech. I am inspired to take action and say hello more often. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are on to our second speaker, Mr. Emmanuel Barrier. Emmanuel will be evaluated by Derek Mandela. Derek Mandela, please go ahead and give us the evaluation project and the speech title.
Thank you very much. Our next speaker is the leader of media, and his name is Toastmaster Emmanuel Barrier. Toastmaster Emmanuel Barrier is delivering under the dynamic project.
Derek, you're on. Please introduce our second speaker to us today.
The purpose of this project all the members to start on the new basic research method and present our work over there.
Derek, your audio is a bit inaudible. I don't know if it's just me. Audio.
My audio better? Hello?
Yeah, much better. Hello.
All right. Allow me to take that again. Our next speaker is Toastmaster Emmanuel Barrier. Emmanuel will be delivering a speech under the Dynamic Leadership Project. The purpose of the speech is for the member to review or learn basic research methods and present a well-organized speech. The member has spent some time researching a topic, and the speech might be a humorous, informational, or any other style that the member chooses. The member, Toastmaster Emmanuel Barrier, has 5 to 7 minutes to deliver this speech. The speech title is, What If You Made It to 60? Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Toastmaster Emmanuel Barrier with the speech title, What If You Made It to 60? Over to you, Emmanuel.
Good morning, Toastmasters and guests. Who is the oldest man on earth that has lived? Maybe I should repeat it. Who was the oldest first man on earth? Anyone wants to answer? I won't wait for your answer. Today, I'm going to share with you about life expectancy. When I was a young little boy in primary school, I got to hear about life expectancy. And I decided to find out in Uganda how many people live up to the age of 60. I decided to look at my community where I am born as a case study. And it is a small sub-county called Kashari, it's in Imbarara. I discovered that in my community, only 4% of the population have made it to the age of 60. Isn't that intriguing? I found it quite interesting that only 4% of my community have made it to the age of 60. That's weird, isn't it? If we bring it to this group, it means that if we are 22 people in this group, only 4% will probably get to meet when they are 60 alive. Where you live may determine whether you're going to make it to 60 years or 80 or not. So I decided to look at other countries, and I looked at Hong Kong. And I found that actually people live up to 80, 84, 85. Why in Uganda are we living up to 60? And what can we do? So I decided to see how many people are born in Kampala, and I used a case study of Kawempe Referral Hospital. I found that every day, 80 to 100 kids are born. 2,500 kids or babies are born in a month, and that can translate into 3,000 or 30,000 children born in a year. Interesting. Allow me right now to take you through my findings, and perhaps I'll be ready to also share with you what I found out while doing my simple research. So I'm trying to make a screen share, and I would like to confirm that you can actually see what I am sharing. Can you view what I'm sharing? Do I have a screen share?
Not yet.
You will give me a sign if I'm there. We are good?
We see your computer files.
You can see my computer files. And nothing more. I'm waiting to receive a thumb up.
You stop share and then share again, and then click on the file you're sharing. Or share entire screen. Yeah. Just stop share and then share again, and then choose the file you're sharing. Yes, that's it.
So you yes.
You want to share in presenter mode? You want to full screen share?
Unfortunately, I cannot see all those icons that can get me there.
Down extreme right corner.
Extreme right corner.
The small arrows at the extreme end down, those four right arrows facing. And if you can see it, but if you can't see it, just go on.
I can't see that, really. So, okay, I've seen them. Good. So life expectancy in Hong Kong could go up to 85.29, and that is my major interest. But when you look at Uganda and a few other African countries, you'll find that our life expectancy is roughly 60 to 64. And this is my community where I come from, where you find that the population aged 6 years and over is at 4.3%. And that represents all other areas in Uganda. That should be something very scary. So without wasting time, I would like to encourage us to stay away from excessive alcohol, as we know what it can do to our liver and to our hearts and healthy meals. KFC, I think, is the common meal in Kampala right now, and of course, inactivity. So be encouraged to get enough sleep and eat healthy meals. If you get enough sleep, of course, you very well know that you will not have diseases like Alzheimer, which may come for lack of sleep. Eat healthy meals, have your vegetables and fruits and all the nuts and coffee. Coffee is said to be supporting communities in Europe and everywhere to live longer. Of course, you need to know more about that, and you may need to come to me and I take you through the deeper research about all this. Do your daily exercises like Alex Agawa does. But what are you doing to live longer? Maybe you would like to share with me as well. Toastmasters and guests, I hope that with all this, we can go back and check out what if we want to make it to 60 years. While we have always known that the oldest man lived for 930 years in history, especially the biblical history. In biblical history, the oldest man has lived up to 930 years. And of course, in Uganda, we haven't had anyone even reach the current age limit, 130 years. But maybe you can make it 60. Let's meet again when we make it 60 years. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Emmanuel, for that informative and enriching speech. Indeed, what am I doing to live longer? I'd say I'd like to get to 100. See my great-great-great-grandchildren. Thank you so much for giving us the tips of eating healthy, sleeping well, exercising, and avoiding inactivity as we endeavor to live longer. And now I'd like to take this opportunity to invite Derek to give us his evaluation of Emmanuel's speech.
Please confirm you can hear me.
Yes, you can, Derek.
Thank you very much, Toastmaster Emmanuel Barria, for that informational speech. And just to recap, the purpose of Emmanuel's speech was for a member, in this case, Emmanuel, to present a reviewed and researched speech. And this depicted a well-researched area of concern. Emmanuel chose to focus on age, something that is very critical to our existence as human beings. What did I love about Emmanuel's speech? Well, for me, it fulfilled the purpose of the speech because it showed us that Emmanuel had conducted a detailed research not only in Uganda, but across the world. He gave us statistics such as that he hails from a sub-county in Barara, and his people, only 4% of his people live up to the age of 60 plus. And that was used as a benchmark for the people in Uganda. He went forward to reference other African countries that have population of people living above the age of 60 with the relevant figures, such as I saw Burkina Faso there, and also contrasted this with other countries whereby we found that the people lived above the age of 60, ages such as 84 and 85, referencing areas such as Hong Kong. So this gave us a worldwide and global perspective to the issue of age. And remember, its topic was, what if you made it to 60? As a researcher, I was expecting Emmanuel to quote some areas or some research projects that he had gathered. I felt that this was missing. I would have loved for you to quote some resources, some journals and reference materials where you got this research for. Albeit you had used a very good a map, or should I say a presentation, which you had some few challenges projecting. However, the fact that you incorporated this into your presentation made us feel that indeed you had researched very well, you had prepared for this project, which is very important. You not only left us with challenges of why we don't get to the age of 60, you also presented us with solutions. You gave us solutions such as you avoid alcohol or excessive indulgence in alcohol, because it destroys our liver. You went ahead and told us that eating unhealthy meals, such as meals from KFC, which you quoted to say that most people in Uganda consume. I would have loved to know what was the source of this statistic, you saying that most people in Uganda consume from KFC. That would have added more confidence in your research project. You also quoted inactivity. I would also have loved to see a research mentioning inactivity as a cause. Your conclusion was to call up to the audience and ask them, right? Do you want us to live up to the age of 60? You quoted someone from the Bible who had lived there over 700 years. You left out the name, it's Methuselah. I would have loved to you to have incorporated that. All in all, Toastmaster Emmanuel Barry, I felt that the speech project objective was met precisely for this particular project, and I urge you to continue to the next project in your dynamic leadership path in Toastmaster. Back to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much. Enriching feedback and evaluation. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the floor is open for the round robin evaluations. I'd like to start with Lucy. Lucy, please give us your evaluation of Emmanuel's speech. Lucy, are you there? Okay, as Lucy, are you good to go? We can also use the chat. Let me, as Lucy is getting ready, let me call on Kevin. Kevin, please give us your evaluation of Emmanuel's speech. Okay, let me try Vanita. Vanita Agaba, are you there? Okay, I will call on Mr. President. Alex, please give us your evaluation of Emmanuel's speech.
My pleasure. It's always a pleasure to see Emmanuel speak. I love his energy. I love his enthusiasm. I think he's on to achieving the triple crown this year. And to be a first triple crown, that is when you finish three levels in one Toastmasters year. What I liked about Emmanuel's speech is, number one, he's dressed for the part. He's prepared. He respected this moment that the club has given him to give a speech. And it's an interesting project also, research and what's it called? Yeah, it's a research topic. And whenever I see this topic coming up, number one, I'm thinking, how long is it going to speak? Because the time I did this topic, I went over time and I was looking out for that. And the time I will keep us honest on Emmanuel's time. But also, whenever I see this project, I'm looking forward to learn something new because the member has gone and researched. And I think he did very well. We could see his PowerPoint was full of numbers. He did very well. Yeah, your evaluator was spot on. I was also expecting more sources when you said 3,000 babies are born every year. Who said that? Yeah. I really wish you can be more authoritative with your information, especially for such a project where you're just giving us out of research data. Well done. Maybe another point that you want to work on is practice, especially if you're going to use a visual aid, you want to practice that. Yeah, you lost some time trying to get your screen share on and also trying to get your PowerPoint ready. You want to practice, and practice some more on how to do that before you go to your presentation. Thank you very much. Back to you, Caroline.
Thank you so much, Alex, indeed, for that feedback. I'd like to call the second last evaluator from our round robin session, and I'm calling on Drisa. Drisa Soro, please give us your evaluation. And I'll call you Agnes. Thank you. Go ahead, Drisa.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. May I not switch on my camera? Thank you. Emmanuel, I'm always impressed by the topics you choose for your presentations. And for this one, it was really a great one. And I like the way you brought this the subject and the way you went through your figures and went around the world to make your point. That shows that you did a lot of research. To present them in a way that interests us, going far, coming back to us, and showing us what to do. It's great. How and what can you improve? There is always a room for improvement, as they say. The room that's never filled, the room for improvement, Emmanuel. So, what can I suggest you as improvement is it's already said, it is the surface sometimes, because in this topic where everyone has an opinion, when you bring sources, you bring more credibility to what you say. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Tresa. And for evaluation, have Agnes. Agnes, go ahead and give us evaluation.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster. Two things I want to point out. First of all, Emma, I was impressed. Your speech was so much fun. I learned so much listening to it. Two things. One is your audience engagement was so good. Where you started off, apart from the question you asked us in the morning, when you all of a sudden brought in Alex about exercise and giving an example, and luckily his video was on, so we could even see the reaction, the effect of you mentioning that. So that's what audience engagement, keep it up. Number two is how you used repetition in a way that I haven't seen in a while. You talked about the 4% even before you brought in the PowerPoint presentation. It was difficult to forget the 4% of the people who live to only 60%. You mentioned it at the beginning. Then you brought in your story of when you were a young boy and talked about the 4% again in your village and how people live to the 4% live up to 60 years old. Then you brought it up when you were comparing the comparisons that you brought up. So I thought it was brilliant using it that way. Over to you, TMOD.
Thank you so much, Agnes, for wrapping that up in a beautiful, beautiful bow. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the end of this segment. And as I refer back to the theme, today's theme, which is kindness, I'm also really taking home the lessons that we've received from our speakers today. Firstly, hello. And secondly, work on your health. Do the right things with your health so that you can live longer and live healthier and happier. Do you know that kindness can really change the world? One act of kindness can change someone's day. Can create a chain reaction that can change an entire society. Take the challenge today. Take that moment, say hi to someone new. Check on someone you've not checked on in a long time. Buy somebody lunch today. Buy someone a gift. Appreciate your employer. Appreciate your husband, your wife. Appreciate your sister, your brother, your friend. Check on the people that matter to you. Remember that starting by spreading a little kindness every day can create a momentous change. It has been an honor and a joy to be your Toastmaster of the day this evening, and I'd like to hand over back to Mr. President. Alex, take it away.
Amazing, Carol. But before I congratulate you, I think you missed one part of this meeting, the education moment. Do you want to recall that?
Sorry. Is that just a moment?
Okay, I'll just share so that we can know where we are on the agenda. Let me see. The guest speaker education moment is next, and then let's have
the report.
So let me check on that guest speaker, and then shall have a report after that. I'll be short. Just a minute. Great. Good morning, everyone. Once again, it's my pleasure to lead you in today's educational moment. And you won't believe what I'll be talking about today. Before I talk about my education moment, I want to recognize a few presidents who are in the room today, beginning with our host, President Carolyn from Anchor Toastmasters. We also have another president, Charlotte Ochieng from club name hard to pronounce. I'll call her later on to pronounce her club name. It has L's and R's, and where I come from, those are the hardest letters to pronounce. Yeah, are there any other presidents in the room, but I might not be seeing. Well, our past president, Moses Otahigwa, is on the call. Derek Poya, past president. Oh, yeah, I believe Derek was a past president also.
I'm actually a current president.
Pardon? Oh, you're a current president. Wow, Osema Toastmasters. Perfect. Yeah, so where am I going with this intro? I'm talking about past presidents and current presidents because my educational moment today is about the president's role. Yes, I'll share a screen for that. Trust me, I was coming up with this presentation during the meeting. You caught me using a very beautiful app called Canva. So I'll present. Let's talk about Mr. President. That was taken last year, I believe in July, because our Toastmasters year begins in July and ends on June 30th. So just before July, we had our club officer induction, and that's me, your current president. I was being inducted into this role by a professor, a doctor, a cartoonist. You all know who Jimmy Spire is, or if you don't know who Jimmy Spire is, watch out for his next cartoon. His cartoons go viral, and he were honored that he accepted our invitation to come and grace our occasion, and he inducted us into our new roles. Behind me is the Vice President Education, Juliet, and also our Vice President Membership, Agnes. And also behind Spire is a sponsor of our club, our mentor, Dr. Christine Navidio, Distinguished Toastmaster. So quickly into it, what are the roles of the club president? Well, the club president is the chief executive officer of the club, and he's responsible for overseeing everything at the club. Overseeing is key there. As a president, I've found it quite easier because I'm just overseeing. Before president, I was vice president education, and before that, I was vice president public relations. I found those roles a bit more tedious than president, believe it or not. As the vice president public relations, you're creating flyers, you're inviting people. It's some work. As a vice president education, you're actually making sure the club meeting has role takers. You're persuading members to take on roles. It's also a lot of work, but as a president, you're just overseeing, really. I must admit it has been easier than I expected. Being a club president, you're really overseeing, and now I can't emphasize that any further. Also, as president, you preside at meetings like this meeting. I'm a presiding officer. I introduced our Toastmaster of the day and she hands it back to me. I really address members. I read out maybe club news or anything, updates. That's really what presiding over a meeting is. As president, you also guide the club through the Distinguished Club Program. Toastmasters might know what this is. The Distinguished Club Program is it's a checklist of what a club should achieve within a year. And Toastmasters International sets these goals. There are 10. And I'm happy to announce that Kampala Sunrise already has at least 7 goals out of 10. And we still have 3 months to go. So we're doing quite well, I must say. My Kampala Sunrise, we always achieve 10 goals. It's a given. So it will be a little bit of, I can't imagine us not achieving 10 goals because the precedent has already been set by the past leaders and we just have to take it on. Of course, as a president, you have to meet regularly with our club, with your club officers. Trust me, we meet. Me, Agnes, Juliet, Drissa, Shamim, and Irene, we meet. You might not see us meeting, but we meet. Our regular club officer meeting is every Saturday when we have a physical meeting. We come early and meet before that meeting. And this meeting is also open to members. So next time we have a club, a meeting at Rosaho, come early and join in our club officer meetings. You might learn something, one or two. As a president, I'll work closely with the area director. Our area director is Hilda Mwesigwa, Toastmaster Hilda Mwesigwa. So we are in touch, especially on WhatsApp. WhatsApp works for us. Yeah, she's always checking in on the club. How are you doing? Do you have new members? Are you meeting your goals? Yeah, Hilda is always checking up on our club. She attends our meetings when she can. You must have seen her at the club contests, those ones she attended, and also the area contest. You must have seen her. She organized that area contest. Everything was really done by her at Rosaho. Also, as a president, with a big picture perspective, the president sets the trajectory for the club's activities. Yeah, you kind of, as a president, you want to set goals, number one, and also give a direction for the club. So if you have been seeing a few things happening, like, let me see, just having vibrant meetings, creating moments at the club, making sure milestones are being celebrated. It's a birthday, and just making sure that the VPM is aware that, hey, Viola's birthday is coming up. Such small milestones are what I see myself doing usually. Just checking on the club temperature, how are we doing? Are members plugged in? Those are simple things I do. Checking on new members, I check on new members a lot, just to make sure they are not lost. It's the simple things, I believe, as a president that makes you an awesome president. Hey, Toastmasters on the call. Yes, future members, we want you. If you're awesome and you believe that you can be the next Kampala Sunrise president, please contact us on my emails and on my phone number. By contacting us, you'll be self-nominating yourself as the next president of Kampala Sunrise. And that's it. There goes my presentation. Back to you, Madam Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Alex, for that informational segment. Indeed, being president is challenging, but it is a wonderful step to take. So please sign up. Kampala Sunrise will definitely benefit, and so will you. Ladies and gentlemen, my apologies, I've forgotten to take our reports. I'd like to welcome our timer to give us the first report.
Thanks, Caroline. Our time is fast spent, so I'll go straight at it. The first speaker, Joanita Nango, we used five minutes, 39 seconds. And the evaluator, Agnes Katushabe, used 2 minutes and 29 seconds. So the first set really used their time very well. The second set had some some challenges, and of course it impacted on their timing. Emmanuel used an extra 2 minutes, used 9 minutes instead of 7. And I believe it's because of the issues with the presentation. So was Derek. Derek also used 30 seconds extra, used 3 minutes and 30 seconds. Yeah, otherwise, congratulations to the first set for speaker and evaluation for using your time very well. The second set, probably next time you can improve. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Viola, for reminding us to keep time. And our second report will be coming from our grammarian stroke accounter, Ochao. Did Ochao make it in?
Ochao didn't make it in.
Oh, he didn't make it in. All right. Then we can use the chat to give our reports on usage of grammar. Did you hear any words or sayings that were impactful to you today? Please use the chat so that we can glean from what our speakers shared with us today. So the chat is open for that, so we can all participate in giving the grammarian report. And you know, because of time, as we do that, I'd like to hand over back to Mr. President. A little kindness goes a long way. Back to
Wow, members, let's unmute. Let's make some noise for such a great job done by President Carol. I want to hear you guys. Please unmute. Let's thank her the Ugandan way.
Woo-hoo.
Well done, Carol. A small story about Carol. Is where both VPEs at the same time. And that was a tough time of COVID, where it was crazy being a VPE during COVID, making sure members are plugged in. And yeah, so Carol was like my VPE buddy. We always exchange notes on how to get the thing done. So yesterday I was looking for a host of this meeting, and I'm like, wait a minute, I have a president buddy. Yeah, so good to see you, Carol, taking up this role, and you've done amazing, amazing. Also, President Charlotte, if you're still on the call, would you tell us which club you're coming from? Because I couldn't pronounce it.
Good morning, Mr. President and fellow Toastmasters and guests. I come from Lerai Toastmasters, and we meet every first Thursday virtual meeting and third Saturday an in-person meeting in Nairobi. Thank you.
Great. Another Thursday club. So you meet in the evening while we meet in the morning. Yeah. So you have a meeting
Correct. Yes. So we have a meeting today later in the evening. And I do see why a morning meeting is so good. There's lots of energy to go around for everybody.
Perfect, perfect. Please share your link in the chat so that we can revenge accordingly. Thank you very much. I know it's 7:31, and yeah, this meeting is almost adjourned, but as you know, at Sunrise, we like feedback from our guests, especially our guests, non-Toastmasters, because that way we will keep knowing our evaluations, or it's a general evaluation really from the non-Toastmasters. And is there a guest who didn't get to speak at the beginning? Florence, I saw Florence on the call. Hi, Florence. Where are you calling in from? What did you think about this meeting? Yes, Florence.
Thank you. I'm calling in from Chanja. I think the meeting was really good. I've not been at Toastmasters for a long time. This is my third attempt at joining it, but I'm glad I came back. The first speaker, really, I thought she was speaking directly to me, because I find initiating conversation a daunting task. So I'm glad I'm here. And and the second speaker also said some very shocking statistics to me. I can't believe only 4% of our people get to stay beyond 60%. But overall, it was very informative, and I was glad to be here this morning.
Great. Thank you, Florence. Just one last comment from a guest who didn't get to speak throughout the meeting. Lucy, are you able to speak? I see you active in the chat, but are you able to speak?
Hello. Good morning.
Thank you so much for today, for the invite. I was awed by the presentations, most of the first one. I will not say much in addition to what the previous speakers have shared. Thank you so much, and Joanita and also Emmanuel for the statistics. And yeah, it's something to work on. There are a couple of takeaways regarding our health and also engaging more with other people. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Lucy. Thank you, everyone. Unless there's an announcement, Lab Officer. I know Agnes shared a form in the chat for guests if you want to leave your contacts behind. Are there any announcements from the Club Officers?
Yes, from here.
Yes, Drissa?
Yes. I would like just this a general announcement. It's important if some of us have not yet renewed, we're still in the renewal season. If some of us have not yet renewed the membership, please take action. If you have difficulties, share it. Don't keep it for yourself. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, Drissa. Drissa is calling on all of you to renew your membership. A good number of you already have. Thank you very much. Kampala Sunrise is in good standing order, but I want to see you stay and give more speeches. So get in touch with Drissa. There being no any other announcements, this meeting is adjourned. Thank you.